Okay, Mamita, any doubts you have? Yeah, so if you create any kind of circle like this, and I'll just duplicate this over here. Now go to modify, right click. First you need to create editable spline for boolean. Even for this also, right click. You can also right click here, editable spline. Okay, so now on the right side you'll get this attribute. Sorry. Okay, so you have boolean option, and before doing the boolean, what you have to do is you have to attach this. Otherwise, it won't work. So you click on this attach, and click it here. Okay. Now, if I just go to this boolean option, so if I just open this spline, click on the spline option. This option you need to select that spline and then choose boolean and which one you need to do for that. So click on this, click on boolean and click on this. Okay, so three different options are this: add, subtract. So when you want to subtract this, click on boolean, subtract. Like, okay. Yeah, any other doubts you have? Any doubts you have? You started? Yeah, it's fine. If you are done with that, that is also fine. Yeah. Okay, so today again we'll have the same thing, but little bit of more complicated model. So if you want to create this kind of model over there, so again using the spline, we can use this, create this whole model using the spline technique. So I have images which is left side, and we also have the front view. So front view, side view, and also we have something called perspective view. So we'll have all this three view. So now if I just go to this radius max, and we need to see the size of this first. So I just created, go to details, and it is 609 by 615. Okay, so you can just name it as 6.09 by 6.15 inside max. So go to this option, plane, just drop. Then go to modify. I don't need any of this segments over here. So one by one. And here, so there is some option called snapping. We can also snap this over here. So if I click on that right, and if I right click, so when I right click over here, there are different options. So we have grid points, we have grid lines. So if you enable that, and if you try to drag this, so it is going to snap to any of these points now. So exactly in the center of the grid, you want to snap this image. You can use this snap tool. And anytime you can just snap it, each other. You can say this. So it is snapping to the grid right now. Okay, so instead of adjusting, or down, you can also see that there is option over here, 00, you can type and you can just do that also. So this is done. So now it is proper. Now I just drag and drop this image, which is the side view. This is the front view. So you just drag and drop front view. Okay. So from this, you just need to drag and drop. Now press F3. Okay. So what is the image over here? So what is the length and width of that? So if I just make it as 6.09, so it is 609, so I'm just making it 6.09, and this is can be 6.15. so So the image is small. Now I can just scale that. So you can also give 60, or if you want to give 609, whatever the values are there. So I can just scale like this. So this is what, now it is fine. Let's just start adjusting this image to the base of this grid. So front view, you have to go and start adjusting that over here. So this is done. Now go back. And here, what I'll do is here I'll turn into right side of that image. So if I just go to the right view, front, this is left, this is back, this is the right view. Okay, so you can fix that. What I'll do it over here is I just want to rotate this. So from the top view, just rotate like this. That's okay. And this image, so this is the image you need to load that over here. So what is the side view? So select the side view and drag and drop on this and press F3. Okay, so we have this both the images. Now from the top view, what you can do is the front view, you have to push it behind the grid. So push it behind the grid like this. See how much you want to bring that back, right? So you can push it back. And this view. And make sure that it is also over here. So exactly on this grid point. Okay. This is fine. Now when you start modeling, I need to start modeling from this view. So Alt-W. And we can start from here. We can go over here and just start creating. So again with the spline tool, you go to this line and just start creating this. Click it here, 2 point. I can do the fillet over there. So I'm just using like this, hard only. Click here and click one more point like that. And right click to finish that. Okay, so then if I go to this front view, you need to adjust this over here. Because this is the leg which you are creating. So I just move it towards this side. Now go to the edit mode. And this is the points. From the front view, we need to adjust it according to this image right now. So this is at this place. And this is the top of it. So you can just start pushing it back over here. So this is where it will come. From the front view, this point it is going to come over here. Little down, that is fine. And this, I can bring it down. So this is where from this view it will be. Okay, so once we have done this shape, now we need to smooth that out. Okay, to smooth that out, you can also use the fillet. So Alt-W. Now this is the thing you need to smooth that out. Go to the fillet tool and make it round. This much round is required here. So select this. This much smoothness here. Now Alt-W. You can also click it over here and then draw this. Now you can just start adjusting the points from this view properly. Just like this. This over here. If this has to be adjusted little left, that is right. So you can just see that. So how much you can do it. Yeah. So from the top also you can just make it little back. So we need nice rounded shape over there. Okay, so any of the point, if you feel that it has to be moved or hurried, this is what you can just do. Suppose I don't need this point, I can delete and I can just start adjust. Okay, so if I right click here, there are different options. Bezier corner. So if you want to adjust only one side of the tangents, you can use that bezier corner. So I can adjust only one side of it. Okay, so if you want to adjust both the sides, use bezier. So you'll be able to adjust on both the sides of that. Okay, so fix it. This is what I want. Just bring it down. That's it. Okay, so we got this shape now. Now you can go to the rendering option, enable in viewport. Okay, so how much thickness you want for this? So you can just do that over here. So you can see that it is little more thick. So come out of that, and thickness you increase little bit more. So this is what it might be. Okay, so once you are done, now what you can do is you can just come back to this. Let's change the color of this to something which is matching. And I have to create on the other side also, so you can select this. And here go to the modifier. And here we have something called mirror. So it will do a symmetry of that on the other side. So if I click on this mirror, it will create the symmetry of that. So click on this mirror. So which axis you need to do, it will show that, and you need to click on copy. So when you click the mirror, it will just mirror that image. We don't want, we want a copy of it to have that effect. And we have different axes for that. Y-axis, Z-axis. And if I open this, mirror option, mirror center, you can adjust with the help of this also. So this is one option. So if you don't want to adjust that mirror option, what you can do is you can adjust the pivot point of this properly. So go to hierarchy, effect, pivot point, and it should be on this black line. Alt W, zoom in. And this is the line which you have to keep this point. Now if you do mirror, you'll not have anything. So it will come in a proper place. So if I go to mirror, now copy, X, Y, Z. So it will be in Z axis. It's fine. Okay, so we have done this part of this image now. Let's check it. How much? So there is little space over there for this. So I can just go to this option, line, vertex, just select this, push little inside, check the mirror, then it is fine. Okay, so now we have done this part. So like this, we have to work on different parts of that. Okay, so save this file. Okay, so anything you need to adjust, you can adjust. First save the file over here. So go to file, save as, name it as chair. Okay, so now we have to work on this part. What is the bottom part? Or we have to work on this part of the leg also. So we'll be just working on that. So first, if you want to adjust this vertex still according to this shape, you can still adjust it over here. So select everything, pull it up. This way, little back. Okay, so now I'll just start working on this part. So again, using the spline tool, go for this line. And from this point, you just start working on it. So this one. Right click to finish that. Okay, so now it is not in the center. So this leg, you can see it, this is at this place. So you need to start moving the leg and this front view also. So just place it where it should be. So that is the place of that leg, and just start moving this, so it is little right also. Go to modify vertex, just start adjusting this for right and little down, and you have to see that it goes inside this. Okay, so that I'll just adjust from this view and see. It's fine, so it can go inside that layer. So I think if I can make this little bit of more thicker, the first part, then this will be fine. Okay, so this is what we have from this leg over here. So I'm just trying to get that. So if you want to push it back, that is fine. Now this leg. Okay, so now we have to create this part of the model. So again, so instead of doing separately, you can also copy this and place it over there. Or what you can do is you can create some kind of rectangle tool. Click on this rectangle tool, and it has to come from there till this part. Okay, so only half we can do it and half we can do it for that. So little bit of fillet I need to give, and back side will be round over there. So you can just come back. First you need to convert into editable spline. Then go to vertex. Start pushing it back over here like this. So this is the place we have. So where it should be at this place. And this 2 point, what you have to do is you have to give fillet. So click on fillet, and we want this nice and rounded. That will be much easy for us to do that all. Okay, so now again come out of this rendering. Yeah. So how much thick it should be, I can just push now up over here. So it is like other things are just a copy of that. We need to place it. So once you have done this, and here also what I'll do is I'll just give little fillet for even this two also. So give the fillet. So little fillet you can give it for that. I'll start duplicating this. Alt W. So here I need one and here I need two. So shift and drag it up. That's okay. And here also I need this place also I need two of that. So shift and drag it up. That's okay. Shift and drag it up like this. So you just start creating like this all the shapes. Here, so all the shapes you can select, just try to give the same color for that, so it looks fine. I can just see that. So and the top part, what I'll do is I'll just duplicate this and it should cover that region. So to cover that, again have a duplicate copy of this like this. And this time I don't want this render in viewport. I just want outline. I go to modifier, which is the tool we'll be using, extrude. Just to close that part. There. Okay. So just by using the extrude tool, we can just add that over here. So I can increase it more if you want, and that is fine. Now we have this. So where and all we need to add different elements right now. So here again, we can just see that here also we have this line. And there is one more line which is coming over here like this. Okay, so you need to see from all the sides of the model, and we have to do that. So here from this point, I'll just add some of the lines. So very thin line it is there. So go to the front view and start doing that. All right, so here we have. I can go to the line tool, keep saving the file and just start doing that. How do I copy the same thing over here? If I can from this point itself, right? So instead of creating a new one, what I'll do is I'll just take the same thing, shift and drag it down. Press OK. And go to modifier. And I don't need this point. So delete that. Delete. Now go to this editable spline. Now you can just see that. Okay, so if I go to this segment now, click on this segment and I can select this whole segment and I can delete that segment right now. So I don't need this whole segment over here, so delete. So we are with this right now. So now we can select these two vertex like this. Go to the side view and bring it down. So till here. Till this one, because I don't want to create again, so this way it will be much easier for us to do that. And select this two vertex, and you can make it as a corner for this, right? So we don't want that. And I can make half of it, and so we can just save time by doing this half of the images every time. So I can make half of it and I can just have that mirror on the other side. So like that you can do it. Or yeah, let's add some point over here. So go for insert. So I want one point over here. So I can add some point in this place. So click on that and I can add some point. Right click to come out of that, and we have this is the point which you have added. And this side we don't need, so you can delete all this side part. So only, and we can just see that this point has gone over there, so you can make sure that it is proper and straight. Okay, so that is the use of this, using all the views. So you can see from the top, you can see from this side, the perspective is where you can just make it like this and select everything, right click and make it corner. So when I make it corner, it will be fine. You can just see everything is in a proper line and go for render. So little thin size we need to do, and we need to start adjusting. Till here. And go to again modifier mirror. M, press M on the keyboard and you can see this. So mirror option will help, press M, copy, and done. Okay, so anytime if you want to adjust it over here, right? So like click and adjust it now. And go to vertex, select this vertex little left. Okay, so now both the sides you need to adjust. You can also use the scale tool and just scale it little so you can touch that part. Okay, and now you give the fillet for this. So go to vertex, select, and use something called fillet. So little bit it should be there, not too much. Select this, go for fillet. Very less. So you can also change the values of there or here. So if you want to change the value of that or here like this. And you can also type that. So if you want 0.001 also, just type. So this is fine. Okay, so now we need to add these lines. So again, between these two of them, we can just use one spline and have a duplicate copies of that. I can go to the front view. Now here I can see this lines. So everything we are just using the same line tool. Just fix it. And from the top view, you can see that where that line should be. Like this, and then start duplicating this. Select this line, shift and drag it on the right side, and give the number of copies for that. So I say give 6 or 7 or 8. So it will come. One more copy if I need. Now I can see this. All the things are slowly we have to create all this, like I just want to change the color again, everything to be the same. Okay. So now again, this side we need to have the duplicate copy of that leg, right? So we need to have the duplicate copy of this leg on the other side, and also here there is one more leg over here. So that is one more leg which you need to add it in this place. You can see that. So it is, if I just show you the perspective image of that. Okay, I think it's in desktop. Yeah. So also check the perspective also, so you can just see that it is having more legs over here. So here is also one more leg is there, here one. It is not having 4 legs, it is having more than 4 legs. So we'll be just adding this leg over here. So let's start adding that. Okay, so again, line 2, just start adding this line. So here, right click. Go to modifier. I think thickness of this should be more, and we don't want it over here. So you can see from the front view, start placing it where it should be. Just have. That's fine. So let me to check. Yeah, so it has to go little out than this part or here. So yeah. And you might need to adjust even this little inside. So go to the vertex, select all of this. Start placing it, fixing it over here. This is fine. Okay, so since it is done. Okay, so now we can have the copy of this over here also. So if I just have, this is the object now. For this also, so there is on the top also, there is some mirror option. Whatever you are using the modifier, or you can also go on the top option is there called mirror. So even that will do. Okay, So you want copy or you want instance of that, you can specify that. So x, y or z axis, what you want to do, offset, which axis you want to do the offset. So if I just in x axis, now you can offset like that. So when you are doing that, you can just see while modeling, I press OK. So we have the duplicate copies of that, and we need to start adjusting in this view properly. So where it should be here. Okay, so now what are the inside parts are there? We need to start modeling even this. So there is one rod over here, so this one, and again we have duplicate copies of that line. So again we'll be just drawing this line. So go to the front view and just try to match that over here. So again go to the line tool. It's only the one line tool which we are using and trying to make the things placement, thickness of this. Little back you want. Okay, so inside this perspective you can just check it over here how we are doing this. Okay, so same thing I want to duplicate, right? So if I just want to duplicate the same thing over here, so if I just try to duplicate over here, what is happening it over here is it is moving in this axis, and then we have to start adjusting over here. So where it should come inside the side view, bring it down and just start checking that where we are placing this, whether it is proper or not. Okay, go to the vertex again, select this. This has to go inside that. I think it is an instance of that. Yeah. Done. Now this design also we can make it duplicates of that, and again we have this option. So go to the vertex. I need to stay, make sure that it doesn't look, it can go inside this whatever it is looking out, and all these small lines again duplicate with the line tool. I think from here to here. Right click, thickness you reduce, and the placement of that. And here also press F3. So it should be rotated. So because it is little slanting, we have to make sure that even this adjust according to this line proper, and then place it over here. How much we can place it from that point. Go to the vertex. Vertex, push it back. And then I'll just start duplicating the copies of that. So shift, drag it. See how much space we want. I don't want instance this time, I just want copy of that. So increase number of copies, place it. Done. So just hold control and just select everything. Okay, and now we need to do this part which is over here, and also this here also we have some of this rods over there, and here also one big. So just start making that on this all the sides. Let's make this side. Press F3, And here I think there is one more line over here, so I think that I didn't do. I think this is one more line which I didn't do, so that is one line which is missing. So I need to do that line, and then I have to start doing it. So select this layer, shift and duplicate this on the top. And here it will not be closed. So you have to go to this option, segment, and delete this part. And this vertex is extra vertex over here. I don't need that. Delete. Now go to the vertex, select this. And just start pulling this up. And how much is the thickness of this? Little less thickness. Okay, so now we'll just start adding the lines over here again. Go to the line tool. So it is the same process. Only thing is it is like time taking, so you need to spend a lot of time on this. There's no other tools which you are using, only the line tool. And this is what I need to do it over here. Okay, so you can see from the top view or side view, whichever the view it is, you can work on it. Thickness of that over here. Now I just need to start adjusting this. Shift and duplicate. Two copies, three copies of it. And this will be much thicker. Now go to the top view. Just start fixing it over here. But come out of this, select this one. Go to the vertex, select this vertex. First, you need to lift it up. Then if it has to be bent like this, okay, so all the views you need to check. So you have to be inside this perspective while checking, and you can work on this top view, side view, front view, and start working it over there. So then on it will be fine. So for this, I need to give a little more thickness for that. Okay. Okay, and one circular shape which is going to come over here. So again, you have this kind of circular shape which is be coming and attaching over there. So you can also combine this, and we can duplicate on the other side and mirror it. So if I don't want to do on the other side the same thing, so first we'll just add some kind of circular shape. So go to circle and draw this circle from this view only. And we have to start adjusting it over here. Okay, so let's rotate a little bit, and then we'll just change the shape of that. So it has to be from the top view, you can just check it. Okay, so there are different options over here. If I just go to view, so there is different option for transformation. So if I just go for world, so this is the axis which is going to change. So if I go for local, you can see that axis changes over here, and it is much easy for us to move in this direction. But when it is in world mode, if I go for any kind of screen, or if I go for any kind of world mode. Okay, so it is little bit of difficult when we adjust with this. So it is better we can go for local, so it is easy to move. So even if I am rotating this object like this, and if I go for move tool again, so it is much easy for us to adjust like this instead of being in the world mode. So world mode, when I go to the world mode, it will be very difficult to adjust. You can see it over here. I have to adjust like this, then I have to adjust like this. So you can go on the top and change into local. Local option is there, so you can change it to local. So this is the axis over here, which you can change it nicely. And I need to move it up also. So it should be touching. Now go for this. Convert to editable spline, and we are now inside the spline tool. Go to vertex, start adjusting this on the top, and just see it over here. Right click, you have bezier corner or smooth, whatever the thing you want to use it, you can use it. And we have this tangents which you can adjust it also. First thing, let's move it up. Let's go for scale tool. And I have to go to the vertex, select this vertex. So it has to be here. It can be touching to that point, so this is where we can just adjust it over here. Yeah. Okay, so for the top, this also, you can also work from the top view if you want. You can just see from the top view how it works. This one, it has to be here, and it has to go up. I can change the shape of this over the way I want. Back, left. And here also. So if I can just go for this, I'll just hide this. So I can see the shape of that, and I can just start at it. Little bit of this shape. So this is how we can just start adjusting the shapes, and you can go for. So anything has to be adjusted down little bit. This is what I can. This is fine. Okay, so same thing what we can do is we can just duplicate on the other side. We don't want it over here, so I just want to duplicate on the other side. So you can combine all these things into a single spline. Attach, click on this attach. So all the things will be like one. And you can have a duplicate copy of this on the other side. So go for this hierarchy, effect pivot point. And go for world over here. Keep this pivot point over here. Okay, so we can adjust in this way also over here. So when you adjust that, we can do it. So instead of attaching, if you want to group it and you want to do that, even group will work over here. So Alt W. Just bring this down. Yeah. Select this. Control. Okay. So all the things are selected. You can also group. So a group means it will place all the object into one folder kind of structure. and name this as a left. That's okay. And it has created one group like this. Now I can go for this pivot point. Less this pivot point proper. And the whole group, we can mirror it. So you can also go for mirror. I can see that. Press OK. So it will come on the other side of that mesh like this. Or here. And now you need to do these two things. Or this. Okay. So that will continue. So any doubt in this till now? Anyone? Any doubts in this? If you have pen drive, yeah. How to? Huh. This is isolate. Alt Q. So you can isolate that option over here. So if you right click, you can also end isolates, it comes back. If you want to work only on one that object, Alt key is a shortcut. So you can focus only on that. Okay, so here I need to still adjust that some of the shapes. So it is group. You can, so anytime we can come back to that option and we can adjust it. We can ungroup also and group also. So this is a one group, and if you want to ungroup, we can go to group option, ungroup. So all the pieces will be separate now. Again, you'll be able to adjust that. So here, since it is an instance copy of it, both the things will get adjusted. We need to decide whether it has to be instance or whether it has to be copy. Yeah, so yeah, any other doubts if you have, you can ask. So who want to practice, you can practice here in the lab. I'll be there to help you. I'll share inside this. I'll share that. Yeah. Or Moodle also can. Yeah. Which one? So this thickness, right? So you can go over here, and here there is option. Let's go for this. Z and you have this enable or render in viewport. Right? Yeah. Press 1, 2, 3. One man. Press 1, 2, 3. So when I go for 1, it go for vertex, 2 for segment, and 3 for spline. Yeah. See. Okay. So if you want to fill that seat over here, so I have just have a duplicate, same copy, I'll just have that duplicated on the right side. Okay, so once this is done, you don't want this over here, so you can switch it off. And you can go for modify, extrude tool. So just fill that. Okay, so if you want to increase the size of that or whatever. One minute, I'll just check. Outside in the sense? Yeah. So if it is like that, it means you have this option, no? Enable rendering, and you can increase the thickness of that. Huh. So there is like two options over here, radius and you have rectangle. So that will work over here. So if you want to adjust only the width of that over here. How much is it? So it will affect both the things over here. So inside this, we have to go to editable mesh. If you want to adjust only the individual size of it. Yeah, so now we are doing only the spline based modeling. So we'll be going through that editable mesh modeling also. So where you can individually extrude or individually adjust that each and every vertex and mesh. So with the spline, we are doing now. So we are just working only on the spline modeling. So you need to upload the assignments. I already shared that link in Moodle. So start uploading the assignments. Let me take that. And those who are here offline, they can be in the lab. So if you have any doubt, you can ask. So practice it in the lab. I'll be there. So you can work on it. Abhishek, Adarsh, Aman, Anant Krishna, Balchandar, Inba Sagar, Suhas, Momita, Prem, Solomon Christopher is not okay. Okay. Yeah.